Hello. Me again, Darwin. As you can tell, I have a new microphone. And I swear, if this is not recording, I am giving up because this will be my third time trying to record this. I've played throughout the whole beginning, twice, thinking I recorded it, but I didn't. First time, I accidentally stopped recording halfway through this section. Second one, I didn't have OBS running. So, I'm super smart, and this is a wreck. This is a mess. I wish I had two monitors so I can keep track. Oh well. Anyways, you might be wondering, what are you playing? Well, no, because you read the title. This is Enderal. It is a Skyrim mod, one of like the biggest ones. It's a whole new game. It's on Steam. It's free. I don't know if it needs Skyrim, but it's being sold as its own separate game on Steam. I suggest you check it out. Anyways, let us get to it. So, I'm going to be kind of speed running it. Yeah. Just so I can get back to where I was. There. So, here's this little spooky thing. It'll make sense what this is in a bit. Horsies. The nutritiousness of meat is the book. Meat is life. Even the Ash people who were populating this world before us knew that. Each time they killed an enemy in a battle, they tore out the liver and heart of the fallen and ate them together with their family. By doing so, just as everyone knows, the strength of the beaten enemy is passed on. But as we're living in a time in which eating fellows is nonsensically seen as barbaric, we, the friends of the bloody meat, have to settle for animal resources. It's a little burnt down building. Little horse thing that you ride as a child. I had one of those. Hopefully everybody did. Ooh. Little Shikan. Shioken. Oh Lord, oh Maker, I can hear you calling. I feel your love. I know about your sacrifice. Without you, I am nothing. A twig on the currents of time. A sheep without shepherd. Free me from my vices and forgive me of my trespasses. Forgive too my wife and my child. Deliver me from my pains and bless us with your everlasting mercy. It is time to go up. Was that the chicken? Yep. There. That is a very big and bright sun. Now, wait a second.
Oh, hey there. I didn't see you coming. So, how did it go? Did you find it?
What is this place?
Where are we? We're at home, silly. Where else would we be? Just mommy, sister, you and me. Now tell me, how did it go? Did you find it?
No.
No? Pity. Maybe you're simply looking in the wrong places. Did you ever think of that? Oh, well, who knows. Say, why don't you go inside and see if you can help mommy with the cooking? The creator was kind to us today and sent a big fat elk right in front of my bow. All right?
Okay. Oh, jeez. I keep forgetting about that. Oh, and another thing I keep forgetting about. This horrible painting. This painting, can't remember what it is called, but it's like a very famous painting and it freaks me out. It's of this crazy man eating his child, as you can tell. Anyways, let's read. Crispy meat, the art of crispy meat. Who doesn't know that? You are looking forward to a nice, crispy piece of meat after a hard day of work. But your useless child, who you instructed to cook it, gives you a charred something instead. You castigate them. But the problem stays the same. You are hungry, which means that there is no other way than doing it yourself. Walk to the fireplace, cut out a big bloody chunk of the animal, and throw it into the kettle. And lo and behold, slowly the pleasant smell of a burned life reaches your nostrils. Or reaches you nostrils, as the book says. Is there anything better than that? I don't think so. By the way, two Elder Scrolls, this man. Who is this man? Can't go in there. Can't go in there. Weird. Here's this painting.
Forgot what a mess I left here. But I was right, wasn't I? A real gem we've got here. Well then, let's waste no more time and get to it, shall we?
What about mom and sister?
What? Now would you look at that? I totally forgot about them. They're dead, don't you remember? You murdered them back then, both of them. But hey, no use crying over spilled milk, right? At least this means there's more meat for the two of us. You still remember how to do this, right? First, off with the skin. Slice up the belly, then out with the entrails. I'll look for a nice sharp knife in the meantime, to cut off the head. I don't think either of us wants to eat that, do we?
Ha 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 ha. But I didn't kill them. It was the masked men.
Oh, silly, what's this again? We both know that's a lie. You did it. I remember it all. First, you set this horrible fire to your sister's crib. She screamed and screamed, and Mommy heard it, but when she finally got there, nothing was left of her but burnt flesh. And, oh gosh, do we really need to go through this again? You know how sad it makes me when you do this. You killed them, period. No matter how often you tell me you didn't, it changes nothing. You hear me? Nothing. Now please, let's start cooking. I'm so bloody damn hungry.
But I didn't. It was the masked man.
In the creator's name, why are you telling these lies? Isn't it enough that you murdered us? Do you really have to bother me over and over with your stupid, pathetic, and pointless whining? You know,
that's mean.
Sometimes I wish the creator would have made me just a little less merciful. Just a little less pious. Because then I would have realized that you were tainted by sin long before any of this had ever happened. And instead of raising you, feeding you, and loving you like a father does, I would have put you in the horse trough right after you were born. Yes, I should have killed you. I should have just killed you.
Calm down, man. It's not that big
deal. Just like you killed us.
It's not that big deal.
And now, you think you're safe because we're all under the earth, don't you?
Stop, man. Stop.
Well, listen up, my child. You are wrong. And do you know why? Because the dead don't forget. Do you hear me?
Calm down, man. You're overreacting.
Now enough of this useless chatter. I'm bloody starving.
Oh.
Bring me the meat, you spoiled brat. Bring it to me. Bring me a nice crisp piece of meat! 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 Bring me a nice crisp piece of meat!
He did not do that the first two times. He didn't go to the deer like I thought he was supposed to.
Let's begin with a question.
Question.
It might sound simple to you at first, but I pray you to think about it. What distinguishes a free man from a slave? For now, however, let us start this story where another one ended 3 years ago, with the death of the Lightborn. For 4,000 years, they had reigned over this world, seven Arcanists, who, through their magic, had acquired eternal life. In a time of chaos, they gave mankind what they thought it needed most, to be ruled over with an ironclad, fair hand. Within just one century, they united the shattered lands, and a single century later, their human origin was forgotten. They became gods, or lightborn, as they let themselves be worshipped as. Yet the longer they reigned, the louder the voices grew that accused them of tyranny. The loudest being that of Narenzul Aranthiel. And he succeeded in achieving what was once thought impossible. He gathered an army, overturned the Lightborn, and gave back freedom to mankind.
Yeah!
However, the price for this was high, because where there are gaps of power, fights erupt. As such, this world grew into what it is today. Shattered, riven, and broken into pieces. But all of this was merely a diversion, so that no one would notice something else. The death of the Lightborn had set something into motion, a clockwork. Having long stood still, its gears now once again slowly began to turn. This is the story of someone who wanted to be free.
What?
Not particularly.
Well, sorry. That was a bit harsh. I'm just nervous, that's all.
Okay.
It was that dream again, wasn't it?
Yeah. Perhaps.
Uh-huh. Seriously, if we had a penny for every night since we met where you woke up screaming, we'd probably be traveling to Anderal in our own starship and... Well, not like this.
What's a starship?
Some things never change, I guess. Do you ever ask yourself if maybe you blame yourself for all of this? For what happened to your family, I mean.
Blame myself. What makes you think
that? Well, there must be a reason that you dream the same thing over and over, mustn't there? I'm no scholar, but maybe these dreams are trying to tell you something. Oh, I don't know.
Nonsense. The people from the temple killed them, not me. I know that.
As determined as ever. I guess you're right. But who knows? Maybe everything is going to be different now. It's strange, isn't it? The way life sometimes goes. Now, if you had told me that a few weeks ago, I would have at the very least called you insane. But if the stories are true, there's no better place for a fresh start. Can you believe it? Apparently there aren't even any slaves on Enderal.
That's amazing. Good.
Only this
don't
whole
get kidnapped in my
blind
sleep.
Passenger thing is making my head ache.
Not our fault that the ship is so poorly guarded, and we couldn't even have afforded the passage fee anyway. Yeah, we're gonna pay our debt.
We're talking about 500 pennies here. Even if we're able to find
Come
a
on,
job over
pennies.
There, we will still need the money for ourselves.
That's $5,
Don't
man.
Fool yourself.
Quit complaining.
What we're doing here is theft, unfortunately. But anyway, what's done is done. I just hope the Andralians are easier on Outlanders than the Neremese are. Your mother was a fugitive as well, wasn't she? Where exactly did she come from? You've told me 100 times.
Skyrim.
And, I just keep on forgetting it.
You know, I'd go through all the lore of the characters again, but I really don't want to. I'm just going to create... I'm just going to, like, go through this. Cordy. Then I'll reload my save as my character.
Araziel. Right, how could I have forgotten? She was one of the few free people who ever set foot on a ship. Anyway. Whew, I'm gonna hit the hay for an hour or so. It's your turn to stand. Wait. You hear that? Shit!
Anyway, enough of the chit-chat. No.
I'll take the salt.
Did I put that key?
Oh, blazes, what do they want down here? The lamp! Quickly! Put out the lamp! Good. Now, quiet.
No.
Ah, here we go. Man, smells like Vautier's balls down here. Shayna, what's that chest supposed to look like?
Small. With the crest of the Blue Island Coalition on it, I think.
Ah, yeah, right. Black Guardian knows what the captain wants it for this shortly before arriving. You go look upstairs. I'll see if I can find it down here.
Okay.
Oh, shit. They don't leave us any choice. We need to do something quick. You take on the old guy. I'll take the young one. Go!
Someone's there.
Bop.
Throw a hook to the face!
Come on, dodge! You can do it!
Don't regret this!
No, no!
Bop. And... dead.
Oh man, oh man, oh man, oh man. That wasn't part of the plan. Not at all.
Shh, calm down, man. Oh, just
what
dead.
What are we going to do now?
Tie him up, gag him.
Yes.
Let's sneak out.
Yes, of course. That makes sense. One of them said it's not much longer until we arrive. With a little luck, no one will notice they're gone until then. Come on. Help me search. There must be a rope or something.
Okay.
And I thought we were over the hump when we made it on board.
It's right there.
It just can't ever be easy, can it?
Poor lost souls. The probabilities have turned against you.
What the? Who are you?
You are confused by my sudden appearance. But my identity is irrelevant. As are you, dear Sirius. Unfortunately.
What? Oh shit, please don't tell anyone we're down here. Please. We didn't mean any harm. These guys were just...
You ask that I not reveal you, for your intentions were not evil. And I believe you, but sadly, it's not compassion that rules my deeds. The first beat of a wing must happen. It is the only way the probabilities will fall into place. This is the way it has to be. The way it has been for eons.
So.
I am sorry.
Unnatural selection is what's about to happen.
Oh no! No! What are you doing? Please! Just don't leave! We just wanted to!
Ah! My gosh.
After we had left Osteen, the two of you hid in the cargo and lived on our stocks. Then when Rick and Sebald found you, you gave them a beating.
Yes.
And all of a sudden, a veiled woman appeared and knocked you out with wild magic.
Jeez.
Is that about it?
Uh-huh.
Yes. I know it sounds crazy, but it's the truth. Please, my dame, we didn't have a choice. You've got to believe us, the war. We just wanted a second chance, that's all.
A second chance. Yes, I think I understand you.
No.
You wanted to start a new life in a new land. And as my ship is one of the only ships still sailing the route since the wars, you were simply forced to board without paying.
Yes, we could work for you, you know? We could scrub the deck, peel potatoes, anything to pay off our debt. And as soon as we've arrived...
Heartbreaking. How truly, truly heartbreaking. But let's be honest. You did have a choice. You could have signed on like all the others did, but you didn't. Instead, you've nested on my ship like flesh maggots, enjoying the good life while my crew actually had to earn their keep.
Why you gotta put it like that?
And now you're feeding me this bullshit about veiled women and wild magic? How stupid do you
like
think
a cloak
I am?
And a mask.
I know your kind. You are cutthroats, filchers. At least have the guts to admit it.
No.
What? No, 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 no.
I have
big
self-pride.
Please, just let me explain.
I don't give a shit for your explanations. If there's one thing I hate more than cowards, it's people trying to pluck my heartstrings. You two are scum. And there's only one kind of punishment for scum on my ship. Pull him up, Ruger.
But Captain, they...
Do it.
Of course, Captain. I'm sorry, lad. You should have stayed in their room.
I'm gonna come fight
but
you guys.
You can't
and
do
you're
this.
Gonna wish
oh,
you killed me,
believe
too.
Believe me, I can.
No, I...
Oh, well, look at that. Someone's woken up. Rise and shine.
You're ugly.
Tie him and his friend together and feed them to the fish. Good luck in your new life,
friend. What
are fish
gonna do
friend.
With me? I'm too big for them to eat. How? I swear. The hospitality of these people are very poor.
People just talk, and
how does it feel to be powerless?
This is about your damn pride, Tina.
I know I'm not real.
That's a mistake.
At least not according to your definition.
I know damn well I'm dead.
It's just...
Crisp.
And there is nothing I can do.
This isn't happening.
But then again...
This just isn't happening.
What is reality anyway?
Selfish fool!
Meditation. You see, we have the Sovngarde Skybox, if any of you are familiar with Skyrim. Assassination. Tempest. And let's see. Why? There we go. Wow. Owie. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little speed run. I'm gonna just grab the stuff. Some Mountie, some empty one, some stuff. I honestly don't know what they do yet. I know what the healing potion does, but I'm not gonna use those yet. Heck. Did it go here? I can't remember. Is there anything there? No. Unless there's something behind that waterfall. Yeah, journal. Sirius is dead and I'm alive. I write these words, but I am not sure if I am understanding them at least one bit. I'm on my own. Apparently I had luck. I'm working at a valley basin. This has to be Enderal. I have a strange... I am feeling strange. Feverish and weak, as well as strong and clear. As if a veil had been in front of my eyes for my entire life, which was lifted now. I am also remembering a weird dream, which I had before I woke up, especially the words of the veiled woman who subdued Sirius and me in the ship's bow. It all begins with the dreams. Remember. I need answers, and I can find those most likely ashore. Find a way to reach England. So, you need to go up there. Some items. Here's a little cave over here. Just a shirtless man. Okay. Next, I need to go over here. Hopefully, it'll be cheese in that chest. Oh, there the rats. Yay! Oh, cheese? Aww. It's not cheese. Aww. Wheat. I'm getting bad loot. Okay. Abandoned temple. Here we go. You're raising your skills with the learning books. Take a look at the book, blah, blah, blah. To use it, go to your inventory. It'll be under consumables. Here we go. This is a spooky cave. Now, here is a spooky part. I have to run in here, bolt fast, collect the stuff. So, certain areas, healing spells and health potions raise your arcane fever. Drink ambrosia to bring it down. Which, this stuff makes your fever go up, and it spooks me so much. Come on, come on. Oh no! Ooh, good. I got out with a very low percentage. Don't want to mess up with that arcane fever, man. I know it's this for inventory, but like, what's the other one? P? F? Oh! Oh, let's say you get the third person. Here I am. H. Tab. Tab. There we go. Tab. Okay. Some keys and some scrap metal lockpicks. Check out a little sewer area, kind of. I don't know if I can wait. I don't even know what the hotkey for that is. Learning book. There's no point in getting that. It's inedible. Okay. Here we go. Okay. This machine. Why does it seem so familiar? You know, I wouldn't really call that a machine. It doesn't look like it would do anything. Maybe? I don't know. It would be a magic machine. You found an ice claw. Ice claws listed in your inventory under consumables permanently raise your carry weight by 1.1 eaten. And honestly, I think it would be better if these, like, gave you more than 1 point, like maybe 2 or 5. Because that would be helpful. Because if there's only one, that means there has to be, like, a whole bunch spread out the island. And I don't even know if that's the only way you can increase carry weight. I hope not. That would suck. Truman Fresh. Why not? I'll take the goblet. in this chest. Oh. That makes me very upset. The last two times, there were 30 and 32 coins in there. Now it's just 16, and I'm sad. Okay. Let me put on my thing. Up here, there is a spooky, scary man. You can't see me. Never mind. I'm just gonna kill him. Power Z, okay. Dumb idiot. You dead now. Psionic push. Now I have shoes. That's nice. Something the people on the ship didn't have. Oh wait, there was a chest. I forgot about that. Hammer? Haunting bow. Nice, nice. This is Enderal. And this is where I'll be ending the video. If it even recorded, which I hope. If it doesn't record, I'm just gonna do a little quick montage intro and then I'll continue on from this point. Oh my gosh, like, you don't even know. I'm not going to record this four times. But I would like to continue this because this seems like a cool experience. I like Skyrim, and this is a new game, basically. And I just noticed that is a town up there. That looks like it could be like the new Whiterun or something. It's maybe Solitude? I don't know. But yeah. I'm excited. I hope you enjoyed this. Yeah, I'm gonna end it here. And I will see you in the next one. Catch you later.